CNC, camera, action. Hey all, this is Sammy from CNC Router Parts. Today we're touching on engraving and machining acrylic, as well as the final assembly of the clapperboard project. As always, stay to the end for a walkthrough in Vcarve and Aspire. I started by cutting down some 1/8 inch acrylic I had on hand. The important thing for this project is that you have at least one gloss side, and that's the side that you'll be engraving on. We'll remove the protective paper from the surface of the acrylic. I'll take my measuring tape and place it against the material. Because I know that the router won't be cutting in on the top 1 inch and the bottom 1 inch of the material, here I can pilot my holes and screw it to the spoil board. I'm using a 60-degree V-bit. The design is a single-line text, so we're engraving an on-the-line profile toolpath. The line thickness will vary based on your V-bit selection and engraving depth. I'll zero the Z depth using our touch plate. Then I'll jog the spindle over so that the center of the router bit is at about my corner, and manually zero X and Y in Mach. Then I'll load my G-code and run the program. Machining acrylic can be a little tricky, and I find it can be helpful to run the toolpath twice so that the V-bit will remove any extra chips for you. I'll switch out the V-bit for an upspiral 1/4 inch bit, also from our starter set. We'll zero the Z-axis with our touch plate, and since we've already zeroed X and Y, we can just go ahead and run our program for the exterior profile. I left the tabs relatively thin, so they're easy to snap and sand off on the belt sander. I have these CNC plasma cut brackets I made, cleaned up and painted. In retrospect, I realized I could have piloted these holes on the CNC, but it's easy enough to mark the center of the holes on the walnut and drill it out by hand. I'll pilot with an 1/8 inch bit and use a 1/4 inch bit for the final dimension. Here I'm using Chicago screws, which will allow the clapper to swing easily while also keeping the components in place. The acrylic has a snug fit, and we can glue this in place with epoxy or use a temporary adhesive if we'd like to have the ability to switch the panel out. After cleaning up the grooves on the engraving, we can use a whiteboard marker to color the V-carve. The ink will stick to the areas where the engraving has created texture, and then you can just wipe away any of the marker on the gloss surface. I find that this technique works really well for creating plaques and signage. Engraving the text or image and then applying the ink or paint, which will stick inside the engraved area, and will wipe away easily on the surface of the material. One of our favorite makers, and we know he's one of yours too, Martin of Vintagatch and Wednesdays, also uses a clapperboard. So we just want to say, hey, thank you for all that you do, and we believe in you and the Marble Machine X. Thanks everyone for watching. Stick around for the toolpath setup in Vcarve. We look forward to sharing more projects and processes with you soon. See you all in the shop. Welcome to our walkthrough in Vectric's Vcarve. I'll open a new file for my acrylic and set the material dimensions. The thickness is 1/8 inch. Once I've confirmed these settings, I can right-click and paste the design. It takes it to the coordinates that it was in the previous file. We can go to our alignment tool and click to center it onto the material. I'll draw out a few boxes on the top and the bottom. I know that these areas are safe to place in my metal fasteners later on. I'll create a profile toolpath, and I'll set the depth to 0.05 inches. The deeper the cut, and the thicker the line will be. For my tool, I'll click Select, and choose the 60 degree V bit, and hit OK. I'll make this an on-the-line toolpath, and calculate. You can see I chose to also engrave the border. This will give the edge a small chamfer and reduce the risk of the acrylic chipping on the surface. Now I'll select the border vector again and create a new profile toolpath. I'll set the cut depth to Z, which will reference the thickness of the material in the material setup. I'll select a tool from the tool library and click OK. Now I'll click Edit to alter the settings of the router bit within this particular toolpath, rather than changing the original settings of the tool database. I'll also add a few tabs. For more on tabs, be sure to check out the pro tip video in the description below. I'll make these 2D tabs. I find that they're less likely to chip out on the surface of the acrylic than 3D tabs, which tend to work better for wood products. I'll calculate this toolpath and preview it. Thanks everyone for watching.